Right guys, so we're back out for another wild camp. I'm out with Di, camping wild with the dragon. And I've actually got his channel name right for a change. So we're actually going up Vanny Beag, and I won't be making any jokes about the name of it. So don't be expecting any of that silliness. I'm a mature, responsible adult, there won't be none of that. But as you can see behind me, the views already are stunning. We've probably got about maybe 2 or 3 mile hike in to find our location. And we're going to have a look. Catch you guys up there. Let's go. Ask us, why do you go wild camping? Why do you go climbing up hills? That's exactly why. Just look at that. That is exactly why we do it. Views for days. Right, so we have tapped out at the summit. We've settled down, had something to eat, had a drink, topped up, rehydrated, and now played drones, met a couple of the local sheep, and I think it's time to start thinking about finding a spot and getting set up. So, I've got sun cream in my eyes, I'm getting attacked by midges, bitten by horse flies, but I'm having the time of my life. Does not get better. Look at that. There's the three big boys. Looking behind me. And everywhere you look, it's just stunning views. Right, let's get that tent up. Let's go. Alright guys, as I promised, today's video not only is going to be going to Vanny Beag, but also I wanted to show you guys that camping is affordable to everybody. You don't have to go and spend £5,000 to go camping. You don't need an £800 Hilleberg solo. You can do it on a budget. And here I am doing it on a budget. This tent is a Eurohike Toco 2. Currently in blacks, it's £15. It's a two-man tent. It's got a 1500 hydrostatic head. Dai's bum is in the way. So it's a 1500 hydrostatic head. It will keep you dry in a downpour. It won't hold for a torrential downpour, but for a downpour it'll be good. There is a cap that goes on the top, but I'm going to keep that off for now just to keep the ventilation going. I'm going to keep the doors open to keep ventilated. So you do get mesh doors to keep the flies and the bugs out. inside here is going to be some real wizardry for you guys that like to go cheap. And this is as cheap as it gets. You can't get a lot cheaper than this, I don't think. So, to begin with, apologies for the red lights. The Caramo Dura I got for 20 quid. I got that from Sports Direct after a tip-off from Trev over at Summit or Nothing. He put over on his channel that there was 20 quid, so I jumped on that and bought it. And it's ideal for a day pack, but you can utilise it for an overnighter as well. And you can see the inflatable pillow that I got there. That's the top one. That cost me £2.50 in Sainsbury's, guys, for a pillow. I've got the Summit light. That was from Head Torch. That was from Aldi. And I think that was £2.99 from Aldi. I got the Adventure Ridge sleeping bag from Aldi. And that was £6.99. And I've got the OEX Traverse sleeping pad. And that was £12. So £12 for a sleeping pad, £2.50 for a pillow, £20 for a bag, £6.99 for a torch. I've got a current little torch from Olight, and I got that for free. Just had to pay the postage, that cost me a fiver. So all in all, I'll put a total up on the screen. And food wise, Aldi squash, chili and lime peanuts, Aldi noodles, more Aldi noodles, pepper armies, and because I'm going cheap, a lot of people pay for 3-in-1 coffees. I haven't got a 3-in-1 coffee, I've just made my own at home. I put 2 spoonfuls of coffee, 3 spoonfuls of sugar, and 3 spoonfuls of powder for milk. Same in the other one. Got the cook set. Was my Odoland camping cook set. I got that off Amazon for about £15, maybe 18 months ago. And that's been really good. I took that on every camp. I don't just do that just because it's a cheap camping for cheap video. And then, just to show off, I've got my Bulldog Badger mug. That cost me about £7.50. I will have some for sale if anybody wants any. Probably gonna cost about £8.50, 9 quid, including postage. But I'm going to put the total on the screen in the corner and you can be up camping probably for 65-70 quid. I will overlay it on the screen for you guys, but it doesn't get cheaper than that. It's affordable to everyone. Now, where I am, Vanny Beag has been downgraded. They consider it not a mountain because the gap in between this mountain and the mountain next to it needs to drop another 5 meters. So between that one, Cribbin, and this one, it needs a bigger dip in between it of another 5 meters or 5 feet. But you know what? Fuck it, guys. I'm calling it a mountain. You can camp on a mountain in a £15 Eurohike Toco 2 festival tent. And I'm gonna do it now. And you're gonna see it, and you're gonna think, wow, we don't have to spend all that money. In the morning, I will talk about, you can do it for cheap, but should you? Is it a good idea to stick this thing on the top of a mountain in the middle of winter? The answer to that is absolutely not, but we'll talk about that in the morning. Catch you in a minute, guys. Okay, guys, so that's dinner done. We've got curry noodles, peas, sugar snap peas, tender stem broccoli, pepperami, absolutely fancy. That's some Gordon Ramsay shit. Now I gotta tell the truth, that is not Gordon Ramsay shit. Right, guys, so we're now relaxing in the darkness, and we just decided to fire up the projector and we're now watching Mr. Wild Wells using the side of my tent as a projector.
We're approaching the Devil's Doodahs
in the middle of the Brecon beacons.
Don't recommend doing this with a full bag.
That's how the other half live. Like that. Yeah. 100-inch screen on the side of my tent. Right, guys, so we're about to go to bed, but first of all, we're going to watch Twin Peaks while camping on the side of my tent using Di's projector.
Look at me, mate.
on the top of Vanibeeg. So if anybody from 3 miles away can see us, then they can see what we're watching.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to take this opportunity to say goodnight, and I'll catch you guys in the morning.
Night, guys.
Catch you in the morning. Good morning, guys. We've had a successful night. Watch the sunrise. Absolutely majestic today. I've never seen one so clear and crisp, so that was nice to see. So I did say I would talk to you this morning about cheap budget equipment. Now I've proved you can do it, and the next topic of discussion, should you do it? The tent held up perfectly. The reason that is because I checked a lot of weather forecasts before I came. I even checked in the car before I left the car. And you should always be prepared for the conditions that you're going out into. And you should always have a plan B. If things turn nasty, I had plan B. Dies over there, I could jump in his. So there's always got to be a backup plan. If you're going to take and gamble on budget kit, just know the limitations of the kit, guys. Take it into lowland, into a forest where you've got a bit of protection from the wind, something like that. But I ain't going to lecture anybody, but what I want to do say, and the purpose of this video, is just to show some of the newer people into wild camping that you don't have to spend a fortune. And I didn't even mention this. This is my down jacket, and I got this off Decathlon, and I think it was like, I'd like to say 60 quid. Now, for a down jacket, that is cheap. And I think this one goes actually down to -6, I think it's rated to. So for now, it's totally overkill. But it just goes to show that you don't have to spend 140, 180, 250, 300 quid on a rab. You can get good old Simone's. And it'll do the job. It'll do you a job. As long as you know the limitations of it and you know that it might not last quite so long. It might not get down to such temperatures and extremes. But you can go out and you can have a good old time for 75 quid plus a jacket. I didn't really need the jacket though, I just put it on. But the whole setup probably cost me about 70 quid, 75 quid, and I've had a good night. So that said, I'm now going to pack up the tent. And I'm going to leave no trace. I'll bring you back in a minute once I've dropped this baby. Okay, badgers, a little bit of flat grass. Leaving no trace, as always. Just a little square where the tent's been. And if you look at the pack, all of my litter, all of my bottles, all my bits and pieces are all in the Sainsbury's bag, strapped onto the bag. They ain't going nowhere. I'll either wait till I get down to the car park and see if there's a bin, or I'll just take it all the way home, either or. And that's the way it should be, guys. Take all your crap home, and if you see any shit while you're out, take that home too. And then you can always come back and enjoy these views. Hi, I'm Kerry.
And I'm Kat.
And together, we are not Team Valhalla. Shout out, guys. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Right guys, we're back at the car park. I'm gonna head home. If you stayed this far, I appreciate you. If you haven't liked the video, press like. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. It helps the channel out a lot. Subscribe to Die, Camp and Wild with a Dragon. I'll leave his description down below. And I just wanna say, it's been a difficult video. A, because I used cheap gear, and B, because I've just resisted the urge to be childish with the title of the video, and I've not said any misdemeanors throughout the video, and I've just been visited Vanny Beag. Take care, guys. Until the next video, see you again.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. The large vagina. So, some of you might be surprised to know that this is not actually my first time tackling a big fanny. Big fanny. Grand Vangita. Massive vagina. Substantial poontang. Large growler. Massive fanny butt. Big fanny butt.
Funny big.
Sizable quim.